stay in Drupal 9. This is not my own slide deck. This is a slide deck created by Gábor Hojtsy, really well known to you. He's a core developer. He works at API and he made these slides open source. Anybody can download them and you can have the same talk at your company, for example. My name is Eelke. You can find me on Twitter, Drupal.org, at Drupal.org. I've been on Drupal.org since 2008. And currently, I am a lead developer at Loods5 since 2015. In my spare time, I'm a father, husband, and sometimes a bit of a gearhead. To understand what Drupal 9 is, we first need to talk about how innovation happens within Drupal right now. There are actually three key concepts that you need to understand innovation in Drupal. And those are semantic versioning, scheduled releases, and experimental modules. First up is semantic versioning. Drupal started using semantic versioning since basically Drupal 8, 8.0.0. And semantic version identifiers have three distinct parts. For now, the most important ones are the middle part, which we call the minor release, which is a bit of a misnomer because actually they're usually sort of a big deal because we get new features with minor releases. Minor release means new functionality, but it's still backwards compatible with previous versions. And then the third part is, we call that the patch position. That's increased whenever bug fixes are introduced or security holes are patched. But no new functionality is introduced. And then the first part of the semantic versioning is actually why we're talking about Drupal 9 right here, because that introduces backwards incompatible changes. Having the way to express that we have new features, and actually we do get new features, that happened in scheduled releases since Drupal 8. Drupal introduced scheduled releases every half year, a new minor release of Drupal is released. And we get actual new stuff from that, which is completely new, or at least as of Drupal 8 it was completely new. What used to be the case is that new stuff was only introduced in major versions of Drupal, and the policy was that we would not actually introduce new stuff in between major versions. That actually meant that, for example, Drupal 8 has been in development for 3 years. If somebody built something at the very start of that development cycle, they would only get feedback from people actually using that functionality 3 years later, which is quite a long time. And of course also for users, they'd have to wait, in this case, 3 years to get new stuff. Scheduled releases means that users get new stuff more often and developers get more feedback quicker. Let me do something quickly in here so that I don't know how much time I have left. The third key concept is experimental modules. Drupal 8 introduced the concept of experimental modules. Experimental modules might not be ready completely yet, for example, accessibility might not be up to scratch yet. And it's intended for core developers to get feedback even sooner. They can introduce new stuff, market experimental, saying, okay, this is not really fit for production use yet, but please have a look at it, try it, use it, and give feedback. Experimental parts of core do have the requirement that they are basically beta stability, which means that they need to be backwards compatible with new stuff. An upgrade path needs to be available. This didn't always be the case. We actually were burnt here and there by that at the very start. So semantic versioning, which allows feature releases, then schedule releases to actually have them at a regular pace, and also experimental modules. For examples, in core version 8.6.0, as experimental, we got a media library in workspaces. Also stable was the demo install profile that you saw. Maybe if you were at the talk from Nick, he actually showed it with the Umami demo profile. And also stabilized migrations for sites using only a single language. And 8.7, still experimental, but due to improved media library and stable, especially the layout ruler, which has been experimental prior to that. And we also got JSON API as a stabilized unit, which actually the first week this was basically lifted from contrib right into core without any changes at all. And then also quite an important part of this whole Drupal 9 thing is third-party dependencies. Actually, since Drupal 8.7, everything that deals with Twig and core is compatible with Twig version 2. You get Twig version 1 by default if you you get Twig version 1 with Drupal if you install it. But everything in core is actually compatible with Twig 2 as well. There's a little asterisk there, which you actually have a pretty hard time getting it installed due to the way the poster works. But if you could get it there, so 8.8 is coming along in a few months, and we'll undoubtedly get new stuff. We don't know exactly what yet, because it's still being worked on right now. So could we not go on like this forever? What happens after this? We can introduce new stuff, new features with minor releases, and everybody is happy, right? Well, not quite. That's why I'm here right now. But why do we need Drupal 9? Well, two reasons actually. It's to clean up our own code base, and it's to update third-party dependencies. Like a quick example, Twig will reach an end of life at some point, and we will need to move to Twig 2. Twig 2 uses the very same semantic versioning ideas, so that means that Twig 2 is going to fully backwards compatible with Twig 1. The Drupal updates Twig, it will actually also become backwards incompatible and needs to increase the Drupal 9 just to reflect not everything is backwards compatible anymore. So there's various third-party dependencies in Drupal Core. Drupal 8 was all about getting off the island, and we started using quite heavily some stuff from other projects. Symfony is the biggest one, but also there's K Editor 4 in there, jQuery and Twig, as I already mentioned. And they have their own life cycles. And actually the most important one is Symfony 3. Symfony 3 will end of life, all support will end at Q4 of 2021. And as I already said, it actually means that support for Drupal 8 and then as well, because Drupal 8 depends on Symfony 3. So basically, unless we were to fork Symfony ourselves and start supporting Symfony 3 or fork ourselves, we're stuck basically with this situation. We don't want to fork Symfony 3 because we'd be all the way back where we were before. So, that means Drupal 8 end of life is also a key for 2021. So that means that somewhere in between now and then, we need to introduce Drupal 9. Well, the nice people that Drupal Core developers are, they said, well, a year would be nice, but 1.5 years might actually be even nicer. So there's only actually two minor versions left. We're now at 8.7. We'll see 8.8 at the end of this year. Then 8.9 at the very same time we'll see Drupal 9 as well. First Drupal 9 release, Q2 of 2020. So that's really close by actually. So now we know what the question mark is. Yes, it would be Drupal 8.9 as well. But right alongside it, the very same day, there will be Drupal 9.0. And then, of course, after that, the same cycle will continue. Every half year, there will be a new Drupal 9.1, 9.2, etc. And maybe in a few years' time, we can have this same talk about Drupal 10. So inevitably, there will be other dependencies that we update at some point. Just to elaborate a little bit on that, it doesn't mean that only Symfony is updated at the time Drupal 9 is introduced. All third-party dependencies that make sense to update right now that have new versions available will be updated at that time, so that we don't keep doing this every few months. So how does that happen? How can Drupal 9 be released at the very same time as Drupal 8.9? Actually, that is because the development of Drupal 9 has already started. In the past, major versions were developed very differently. What happened was a new major version was released. For example, the last time this happened was when Drupal 7 was released. I think it was at the DrupalCon, and released with some little ceremony, would actually create a new branch and say, okay, we've now started developing Drupal 8. And from that point on, everything was possible, basically. If you thought you wanted to rip out some part of Drupal and replace it with something much better, you could do that. The result was that, fundamentally, my major versions of Drupal were incompatible with each other. Stuff was changed, replaced by new and better stuff, but it meant that old code, old contrib modules, old custom code for sites that you might have built did not work by definition. And moving from one major version of Drupal to the next is actually quite a lot of work. You have to rewrite stuff, you have to wait for contrib modules to become available again. So, big pain in the ass, basically. For Drupal 9, things are going to be different. Drupal 9 is going to be fully derived from Drupal 8. It's just a natural evolution, basically. And to understand how that works, I need to tell you about the deprecation process. It basically means that when new stuff is introduced, the old stuff is still kept around for a bit. It allows people to move over in their own time to the new stuff while the old stuff still remains working while they do so. So for example, let's say this is the Drupal 8.7 API and it introduced some new solution for whatever, which actually replaced something existing with old, and it was deprecated, and I'll tell you what that exactly means in a while. Oh, and also something 3 is here, right? It continues on for a little bit, and we end up with this situation, Drupal 8.9. There's some more new stuff introduced. Symfony 3 is still there, but there's also more deprecations. So what happens for releasing Drupal 9 is actually this. The deprecated stuff gets removed, the third-party dependencies are updated, and that's it. Nothing new. Well, the examples are tricky to Symfony, will be updated to Symfony 4 or 5. It hasn't been decided completely. I think it depends on how easy it will be to transition to Symfony 5. Symfony 4 compatibility is like one core issue off, I think. Anyway, that will be either Symfony 4 or 5, and of course 5 will buy some extra time for Drupal 10. So there you have it, Drupal 9 API is a Drupal 8.9 API, minus deprecated parts, plus third-party dependencies updated. That's all there is to it here. That also means that DrupalJam modules that do not use any of those deprecated parts over there will just work on Drupal 9. So moving to Drupal 9 should be easy, right? And then of course, after all this has happened, and we have a new clean Drupal version, everything happens all over again. We just continue, introduce the new stuff, deprecating stuff, and then at some point Drupal 10 will come along and the whole thing will start over again. So what's important if you have a Drupal 8 site at the moment is how do you make sure that your transition to Drupal 9 will be as easy as possible? How do you prepare for Drupal 9? Actually, it has Drupal has some patterns and processes in place that make these deprecations clear and findable for you. So let's look at an example. This is an example from Drupal 8.7. Before Drupal 8.7, we had the function file unmanaged copy. It would just copy a file from the source location to a destination. That is now being deprecated in Drupal 8.7. The way to do it now is with a service called file system. Why is it replaced with a service? Service just doesn't do only this, it does a lot more things and, related to the file system. The advantage is, for example, service has an interface. It's just an interface to find a single file that you can go through and see what that service does exactly. Instead of having to hunt through a bunch of functions with file underscore, seeing if you can find what you were looking for. Also, service can be replaced. You can actually swap in an alternate implementation of a service for example, if you have a situation where you need, I don't know, a cloud file system, you can swap it in and replace the core stuff with your own stuff. In the same vein, it makes testing a lot easier, because if your code depends on service, it's also easier to put in a very basic version of that service just for testing. And while in general this is more in line with how Drupal does things nowadays. Of course you should be doing this with actual dependency injection where you can. But there you have it. So, how do we find out if we were using file unmanaged copy that we should no longer do that? This is what file unmanaged copy looks like right now. Obviously, there's the old documentation, but you will also see the add deprecated tag in the dot block up there, and you see the trigger error code. The deprecated tag can be used by automatic analysis tools, but also, for example, if you use PHP Storm, you will also make use of it. You'll actually get a strike through the function name if you have it somewhere in your code. The trigger error is for runtime. You could, for example, test for it. It will only trigger an error when you actually have the error level either deprecated or enabled. But you could do that when it tests, for example, to find when deprecated code is hit. And, well, I already told you about PHP Storm that will do this. There's also another pretty cool tool that will look for the user deprecated APIs in your code. The next slide will start a little animated GIF showing you how it works. It's called DrupalCheck, and you see being downloaded using curl. And then after it's been downloaded, it's being run against the path module in core. It's actually created by Matt Layman, who works for Centaur, which you might know as Commerce Guys. And it makes use of PHP Stan, a static analyzer for PHP. And it tells you all the deprecated functions used in that code. And so you might be wondering, yes, there actually is use of deprecated code in the core right this minute, which all needs to be cleaned up before we can actually release Drupal 9. For example, you could include this tool in your CI process. What we've done once you is we have a maintenance script which we run regularly on projects is to keep modules up to date. We've added this at the end of the maintenance script so that you also automatically get shown what deprecations are in custom code. You can fix them right at the same time as you do regular maintenance. It's downloadable from GitHub. You can actually look for it, or if you like, I can give you a URL. Another tool that might also be interesting is something that you can install within your Drupal site itself. It's called Status Manager. Upgrade Status. And this is a little video giving a demo of what it does. You can start a scan. Basically, it is the same thing as DrupalCheck does. A lot of covers, but it gives you a nice web UI. You can actually view errors while it's still scanning. It shows you information about the deprecations. You can click links and go to api.drupal.org, which will then also tell you about the deprecation and what you should be doing instead. And you can also get a nice HTML report for all the errors that it found that you can then use to do fixes, or if you're a developer yourself, give to your developer and do fixes. Are there any maintainers of Loods5 modules in your room? Great. Well, this is something for you. You can do two things basically on Drupal.org. You can tell it to use PHP stan. You say enable the PHP stan, and it will use the look for the deprecated tags. So it's basically doing the same thing as the CLI Drupal check tool. And then for the other variant, you can actually have you can turn on the suppress deprecations off. You'll actually get errors for any trigger errors of the deprecation type. This is also pretty neat. I didn't try it myself. It sounds really cool. It's a proof of concept that it's based on Rector. And this will actually create a patch for you that will fix your deprecations. It's created by Tessio Pisco at Profonics, if you were wondering. So, now that you know all this, should you remove all deprecated code use immediately? Well, I definitely stick around for at least a pub quiz tonight. Then it's Friday, so we also have just a nice weekend. But Monday morning, custom code as fast as feasible. Like I was saying, maintenance run, the regular maintenance on your Drupal site is a good time. You might be updating Drupal core as well. You might have a bunch of new deprecations at that time. And fixing them right that minute is a good idea. Contributed project is a bit different because Drupal has the policy of supporting one minor version back. We're now 8.7. 8.6 is still supported. That means that everything that was deprecated from 8.7 onwards is still the right way to do it in 8.6. So if you do those deprecations now, you can become incompatible with Drupal 8.6, which is not a great idea. So basically, you could fix now the deprecations from Drupal 8.6. You'd be basically okay. It's also possible now for your contributed module to indicate your plans for Drupal 9. You can link, for example, to an issue where you keep track of compatibility issues with Drupal 9. You can indicate to users what your intentions are as you plan to support Drupal 9. And of course, if you are going to select a module for your site, it's also a good idea to have a look at that, because if your contrib modules are not compatible with Drupal 9, obviously you'll also be in trouble when you need to move to. So, when will we know everything that will be deprecated? Are there, for example, going to be deprecations in Drupal 8.9 that are then immediately removed from Drupal 9 itself?
Well, no.
Drupal 8.8 will be the last version that will have stuff deprecated for Drupal 9. So from basically when 8.8 is released, you fix all deprecations that you find, and you should be good to go for Drupal 9. Now this might be a big question that you have. Will contributed modules be compatible? What's the situation there? Start of 2019 there was a mid-camp and people did a scan. Wayne McDaniel from Pantheon did that scan on all of the trip. And this is what he found. So this is around March. Actually 48% at that time of the trip was already compatible. It did not have any user deprecated functions. Further 35% at 1 to 5 issues, and then 17% at 6 or more issues. And of course, how this compares to your site, you need to keep running a check on your particular site and see what the situation is there. Most deprecations are actually easy to fix. It's that example of the file and nice copy is not at all atypical. Usually that type of thing, you replace one line with another that basically does the same thing on in a slightly different way. What the people at the midcamp also did was they created 300 projects, they created deprecation reports. So if you are maintaining a module, you might already have an issue. So there you have it. Big Man Trees himself said the big deal about Drupal 9 is that it should not be a big deal. If you're asked what the biggest feature of Drupal 9 will be, is you can say easy upgrades. Because that is it. No more rebuilds of your site. There are undoubtedly going to be some hurdles to overcome. It's going to be a hell of a lot easier than it was in the past. Moving from Drupal 6 to 7 or from 7 to 8. So, what you used to hear if you're on Drupal, try and skip a version and then migrate to the next one, no longer really true. If you're on Drupal 7, you could actually start moving to Drupal 8 right now and then. Just keep up with everything, you'll be ready to do Drupal 9 as well. Having said that, this is how it would be historically, and don't worry, this is not how it's going to be. I said before that Drupal is currently supporting one minor version back, we're also supporting the previous major version. And what used to be true is that when a new major version was released, the previous version would still be supported, but the one before that would have its support dropped. For example, when Drupal 8 came out, Drupal 7 had its support dropped. Actually, not quite. It had 3 months extended support. Well, for Drupal 7, it's going to be even more, because Drupal 7 support will be extended right until the same time as Drupal 8 is supported. And then again, if that's not enough for you either, we'll basically have the same situation as with Drupal 6. There is currently commercial support for Drupal 6 sites still. You can pay a vendor, and that will mean that you get security patches for all modules, all the Drupal modules that you have. The same will be true for Drupal 7. There will be commercial support available. Of course, the question is how practical what it's going to be for you. You might have be a vendor, obviously, you might have your own vendor. So that remains to be seen, but the same plan will be available. Also means that security patches will be made available to the community. But if you don't pay one of these vendors, you're not guaranteed to get security patches for maybe some computer module that you're doing. So, when you do decide to take the plunge, move from Drupal 7 to, well, Drupal 8 basically, you can start going to Drupal 8 now, there's a few tools at your disposal. For the contrib modules, there is a version of the upgrade status module that I showed you before in the video for Drupal 7, and this has something slightly different from Drupal 7. It basically shows you the alternatives there are for the modules that you have on your site for Drupal 8. If there's a version for Drupal 8 or if there's not, then it will also suggest a replacement if it is available. For custom code, there's the Drupal module upgrader. That's a project that will do some of the porting for you. And then for content, actually Drupal has since Drupal 8 migrated core. That will allow you to migrate your content. Neither of these are foolproof, obviously. They will get you around 70, maybe 80% of the way there. There's still work to be done. But at least you can start. And then again, this is the situation for Drupal 9 compatibility. If you move to Drupal 8 right now, this is the current situation. The situation in March, obviously, when new deprecations are introduced in new Drupal versions, these numbers will be negatively impacted. But then again, the trip maintainers will also be fixing their deprecations, which will have a positive effect. So, basically, I think we can be very confident that that 38% will become higher and higher. And just keep an eye on the modules that have still deprecations when Drupal 9 starts to become close, because then you might have to look at either alternatives or actually submit some patches to those modules to get those deprecations fixed. Of course, when you're moving to Drupal 8 from 7, use Drupal check vigorously to make sure that you don't use any deprecated stuff. Everything is Drupal 9 compatible. And there we have it. Recap. Drupal innovates twice a year, and it will continue to do so also after Drupal 9. It will be minor releases every half year, basically. Drupal 9 is currently being built in Drupal 8 step by step. And if you keep up with Drupal 8, with all the deprecations, keep scanning for them, you are prepared for an easy Drupal 9 upgrade. For Drupal 7 sites, unlike in the past, there is no reason to wait until Drupal 9. You can start building right now, and if you keep this in mind, you'll be able to move to Drupal 9. And then also there will be extended support for Drupal 7. Behind the video over there. Like I said, these slides are open source. You can find them at that URL. Basically, everything that I've told you is already is also on Drupal.org and Drupal.org/docs/9. The slide deck was created by Gábor Hojtsy, and he's had some help with the design of the icons and photographs. Thank you. And I'd be happy to take some questions right now.
Yeah, thank you for your presentation. And I'd like to know what your vision is about the biggest challenges.
You mean for releasing Drupal 9 or the biggest challenge is probably getting everything cleaned up, although I'm pretty confident that will happen and that we need to handle it from that. But obviously as you saw that there are still deprecation uses of deprecated code within core itself, those need to be cleaned out obviously before they can be removed. So that's a small risk. And then if you are on Drupal 8 yourself with a website, then the trip is something to